to my channel Complemental Economics. And today's class it's about the last topic of fifth chapter, which is one of the application. In the previous class, in the previous video of mine, I've already done with one of the concept, which is price ceiling. So this is one of the application when we have a demand and supply, they both are going to intersect, when they're going to create an equilibrium. What is the use of that? Why we are reading that chapter? What is the application level? In the real world, you can apply this theory this ways. In the price ceiling, I just gave you one of the example topic, which is PDS, public distribution system. And today's concept, what we have, that is price flow. One more example application level, why you need equilibrium, why you need demand and supply theory to intersect, and how we're going to decide lot of concepts and very important wage, it can be wage theory, MSP, which is minimum support of price. How are you going to fix prices? How are you going to decide wages? That to give example theory, so we have price flow. So through this you can come with lot of other theories too. Maximum theories in economy in the world that is decided through equilibrium theories. But right now I'm coming with one more example topic, which is this particular question you have for 4 marks, and let me go over there. So the topic is price flow. So you have a diagram, so exactly like a price ceiling, but very little changes we have made in it. So let me go with the content wise. Price flow, in the price ceiling, we have fixed the maximum upper limit. So in this, we are fixing the lower limit of a price. So definitely this is fixed by government. The first concept, the government sets a minimum price of few of the goods. So at the same time, the government imposes the lower limit. Price ceiling is upper limit, price floor is a lower limit. So definitely when I'm talking about exactly the concept, you might not understand. I'll explain what exactly it is. The two example theory which I'll discuss today, that is minimum support price. And in your textbook, they have explained one of the concepts, which is minimum wage legislation. So in this, the price what government is going to fix, that is higher than the market determined price. The market price, if it is 40, the government is going to fix 50 rupees higher than the market determined price. So now let me go with this particular. Let me explain what exactly MSP is. Minimum support of price. Most probably, usually in general, you most probably have seen your parents, your any family member, when they're going to visit any market, when they're buying vegetables, especially I've seen a lot of examples when it comes to vegetables. So this is related to agriculture sector. The first one, which is minimum support of price, it is related to agriculture sector. So let me talk about that MSP. So when you visit a market, so you want to purchase a tomato. Being a farmer, so if I'm producing tomato by spending 10 rupees, and because of this equilibrium, the market price is really less. For an example, I have spent 10 rupees to produce any of the product, any of the crop, yeah, any of the vegetable. 10 rupees I'm spending, but the demand and supply are equal to create one price. The price is 8 rupees. Demand and supply is equal at 8 rupees and actual price is 10 rupees. I have spent 10 rupees to produce this. Don't you think a farmer is going to face a loss in this? If he is going to face loss, so how he is going to fulfill his all needs at the same time in the future? How he is going to invest? He borrowed a lot of money from a bank. How he is going to repay when he is facing loss? That's not possible. That's the reason when he is spending 10 rupees, at least he should get 10 rupees, leave the profit part. So if he is not getting the profit part, that is fine. But if he is not getting the minimum cost also, so then definitely he is going to face lot of consequences in the production process in the future, at the same time bank consequences also. So that's the reason when this particular price in any market, the price is fixed lower than the cost what you have spent. So then the government is going to interfere. Instead of 8 rupees, they're going to give him 10 rupees. This is called minimum support of price, MSP. Actually, this is quite discussed every time in the newspapers, minimum support of privacy. We read like MSP only. So this is the concept when any price is fixed in the market because of supply and the demand, that price is really lower, the farmer cannot bear it, so that time government is going to fix the higher the prices. That's called minimum support of price. On the other side, you have the next theory, minimum wage legislation. In this, what is going to happen is, when any labor is going to work in any of the activities, any of the production process, if the owner is giving very lesser price, if demand and the supply, demand of labors, demand of supply is fixed, any of the wages. For example, here demand and the supply, they both are equal at this point. And what is the wage fixed instead of P? Here you have to consider W. W is nothing but a wage here. So here you have a wage. The demand is equal to supply in this point and wage is decided this. If this wage is not enough to lead anybody's life, that time the government is going to tell, it's going to bring its legislation, it's going to make a rule that you cannot offer a wage which is this, which is represented by demand and the supply. You have to give this much of wage. This way, the wage will be fixed higher by checking whether this wage is good, whether the laborers are really able to survive in this or not. The same way, so the MSP and the minimum wage legislation, they both work exactly same. They both are very different concepts. This is related to agriculture crops and it is related to labor's wages. Who is going to decide this? Government is going to decide by seeing what? By seeing the equilibrium. So now I'm going to bring this diagram explanation. In x-axis you have quantity, as you are aware of. And on y-axis you have price. So let me eliminate W here. So in this, demand and the supply, they both are intersecting at one point. You can see here, they both are intersecting at one point. That point is called equilibrium point. And the price, where they both are equal, this is called equilibrium price. And the quantity, where they both are equal, that is called equilibrium quantity. Where supply is equal to demand, that's called equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. So in this case, if price increases, can you see the price got increased here? Price got increased to PF. The price got increased. Who is increasing this? Government is increasing because it thinks price should be increased of tomatoes, any of the crop, because the farmer is not getting his cost also. At the same time, if you come to the wage theory, the wage which is fixed by the demand and the supply, it is not enough for anybody's livelihood. So they can't survive, they can't get the basic needs. For this reason, government will interfere and it is going to increase the price. If the wage is increased, you can consider as a wage also, you can consider price also. Now wage or price, if it's increasing, in this situation you can see other two points will be created. So this point talks about the demand and this point is going to talk about supply. So after this equilibrium, when you see price is going to increase, demand is decreasing because it's moving towards the left. And supply is increasing because it is moving towards the right side. So what we got to know is the demand what we have, that is QF, and supply what we have, that is Q dash F. In this situation, QF is greater than Q dash F is greater than QF. Supply is greater than the demand. So the situation is excess supply. So which one is greater? You can see the gap. The gap between the supply and demand, it is going to talk about excess demand, excess supply. When price increases, always you see excess supply. In the price ceiling, we have seen excess demand, because in that, the price ceiling, prices got decreased for few people who can't afford the basic needs. Here, the excess supply. So this is the topic. So I hope you got this now. So here also I have written the same thing. Quantity supply is nothing but Q dash F, which is this. Demand is nothing but QF. So Q dash F is greater than the QF. If you see this point and this point, which one is the greater? Definitely this is the greater and this is the lesser one. If you're talking these two points, which is more? Supply curve is greater than the demand curve. So this gap talks about the excess demand. That is what I have written here. So I hope you understood this concept. This is one of the last concept, not one of the last concept of fifth chapter. In the next class, I'll be continued with the sixth chapter, which is imperfect competition. Thank you so much. Keep watching my videos. Thank you.